timely and accurate medical diagnosis is key to successfully managing a disease and suspected health issues. But a lung disease known as Alpha-1 is often misdiagnosed, taking up to 7 years and multiple physicians before an accurate diagnosis can be made. Our next guest is here to talk about Alpha-1 and the long journey patients experience before being properly diagnosed, as well as how medical professionals can better diagnose Alpha-1. With us today is Dr. Robert Sandhaus, director of the Alpha-1 program at the National Jewish Health in Denver, Colorado. Good morning, doctor.
Thank you very much for having me here.
I'm so glad you're here because this is something that I think a lot of people have not heard of. Alpha-1.
Absolutely.
Tell me exactly what it is.
Well, it's a genetic condition. Alpha-1 actually stands for Alpha-1 Antitrypsin Deficiency. A little hard to say,
yeah, it's a big word there, but
nice to have
is
Alpha-1.
Good.
And it is much more common than people realize. It's about 3 times as common as cystic fibrosis, a genetic condition that everyone's heard of.
And you know, I'm a carrier for cystic fibrosis.
Really?
My husband is not, thank goodness.
The head of the NIH is a carrier for Alpha-1.
Look at that.
So there are about 20 million carriers of Alpha-1 in the United States alone.
So why is it so often misdiagnosed?
Well, it can be sort of a chameleon disease. It masquerades as other diseases. It can cause liver disease in newborns. It can cause lung disease in adults and eventually liver disease in adults as well. And it's liver disease that looks to all the world like cirrhosis. It's lung disease that looks to all the world like emphysema or chronic obstructive pulmonary disease, COPD.
So would you categorize it as a rare disease, if you will?
Well, it technically is a rare disease because a rare disease is defined as a disease that affects less than 200,000 individuals, and we're probably just below that level.
And typically, does it affect more men or women or both?
It actually affects men and women equally. And so unlike the impression that COPD affects men, in fact, COPD affects men and women equally now. And the problem is that there's nothing specific about how an Alpha-1 patient's lung disease looks to a doctor or mm-hmm. to their family. The only way to know that someone has Alpha-1 is to do a simple blood test.
And a couple more questions. In terms of age, is there an age range? And what are the symptoms that would manifest?
Well, in newborns, it's always liver failure. Fortunately, it's a rare complication of Alpha-1 to have liver failure, but it's the second most common reason that kids get liver transplants. And in adults, it shows up as shortness of breath, often with exertion, wheezing, frequent lung infections. There's a group of symptoms, but they look identical to the symptoms of someone with chronic asthma or COPD.
And if someone's diagnosed, I mean, is there hope? Is there something that can be done to help them?
Absolutely, there is. For the lung disease, you can replace the missing Alpha-1 protein with intravenous infusions, and that halts the progress of the disease. Unfortunately, emphysema can't be reversed yet.
Correct. Okay, doctor, I want you to stay right there because when we come back, we're going to get up close and personal as we meet an Alpha-1 patient. She's got an amazing story. You're going to want to tune in. The Balancing Act, we'll be right back. Welcome back, everyone. Continuing our discussion now of Alpha-1, a lung disease affecting 1 out of every 2,500 persons. Here today again, Dr. Robert Sandhaus, director of an Alpha-1 program at the National Jewish Health in Denver, Colorado. And joining us now, a woman who's graciously offered to share her very own Alpha-1 experience and her path to diagnosis and management of this genetic disease. Her name is Peggy Iverson. Good morning, Peggy.
Good morning, Olga.
Thanks so much for being here.
Thank you.
Doctor, thanks for sticking around. Peggy, let me start with you. What's been the most difficult part, let's say, of this journey, Alpha-1 journey?
I would say it's the loss of my mom,
who was diagnosed
with Alpha-1 antitrypsin deficiency. My children are carriers. I have 2 sons. And then watching others be diagnosed late with Alpha-1 and suffering with lung disease, advanced lung disease.
But as a result of your mother's death, and I am very sorry, you obviously then found out a bit earlier, I would think.
I did. I'm really fortunate to have been diagnosed in my 20s because my mom was short of breath, mm-hmm. you know, and couldn't figure out what was wrong because she had never smoked. Mm-hmm. And she was diagnosed correctly and lived for 9 years after her diagnosis because there was no treatment back then. This was in the 70s and 80s. And so because I was diagnosed young, I've been able to make healthy life choices. And we also were able to follow me and know when lung disease began. So I was able to get on augmentation therapy to help keep my lungs stable and protect me.
Doctor, I would think Peggy's very fortunate, because you and I were talking a few minutes ago about how it's so misdiagnosed. She's not obviously one of the common diagnoses that we've been talking about.
Right. As you mentioned, most people don't get diagnosed until many years after their symptoms begin. But thanks to family testing, yes, which is one of the things that we're really pushing now, once we identify an Alpha-1 patient, we extend that testing to their entire family and pick up a lot of people before they get disease.
And what kind of testing is being done now as opposed to the family testing? Well, that one is a little bit more accurate.
The testing is simple. It's usually just a finger stick blood test. There are free test kits that that are provided by many companies that allow doctors to do as much testing as they need to do on their patients. In fact, the American Thoracic Society, the European Respiratory Society, the World Health Organization have recommended that every patient with a diagnosis of COPD or chronic asthma as an adult get tested for Alpha-1.
And it's really easy to do if you think about it, because if you do have those symptoms as a result of maybe Alpha-1, just to get that test could really mean the difference between life or death?
Absolutely, because there's that specific therapy that wouldn't be provided if you didn't have that diagnosis.
Peggy, I want to end with you, and I want to thank you so much for sharing your story
you.
With us this morning. Any advice you'd give to someone out there that could be suffering from those symptoms and wondering, you know, what is it that I have, or goes to the doctor, has been to six doctors, and is clueless?
Absolutely. Please be diligent and get tested for Alpha-1 antitrypsin deficiency. It's that simple blood test. Go the extra mile, and please do it.
And really extend your life and lead a productive life,
yes,
as well. Peggy, I want to thank you so much for being
thank
here.
Thank you, Olga.
Thank you for sharing your story.
Thank you.
Doctor.
Thank you.
Thank you for all the information. And if you'd like to find out more about today's important medical information, visit us at thebalancingact.com. And of course, share with us anything related to today's topic on our Facebook at The Balancing Act Fans.